Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the lecture series of data quality management. Now today in this lecture, we are going to learn about a very important topic of data quality, that is profiling, or in normal language, I call it as profiles. Now, how do we create a profile in data quality? For that, we need to understand the basic knowledge about what is a profile. Now, to understand the basic information about the profile, let's understand some more detailed about it. So here I start with the basic topic called as data profiling. So where this data profiling came into existence? This is the premost question which is being asked in every interview or every mind. So profiling is basically related to some of the misconceptions or some of the errors or some of the unwanted data in the database. So in multiple processes, or I call it as in data warehouse design, many professionals face a situation like there is data inconsistency. By inconsistency, I mean missing records or there are null values which result in inconsistency of the data. Or there may be a time when the primary key column which is chosen by us is not a unique. We know that the primary key column has a property that it should be not null and unique, but the column which we selected in the database as a primary key is not at all a unique column. It is not containing the unique values. Then it may lead to problems in the future. Or it may be possible that the schema, the number of columns, the type, data type of the columns, the length, precision of the columns is not what is required by the end user, or it is not compatible with the data which is required to make an end user project. So the design of the schema, the design of the database is not incoherent to the requirement of the client system or the client end user, right? And it may be possible that sometimes your data is giving you unwanted errors, or it is returning you unwanted rows. So in that case, we need to look into these small issues, small points before making a high end project, or before delivering the data, high end clean data, pre-processed data to the client, so that a very good software could come out of it, right? So what is the role of profiling here? The role of profiling here is to make a thorough assessment of data quality. So how data is good quality wise? Does it follow all the dimensions? Does it contain null values, or does it contain missing values? So we need to look into the thorough assessment of the quality of the data, of the source data. We need to understand that what could be the possible anomalies in our data, and we need to discover them so that they could be sorted out and they give us a very good product at the end. And we need to understand the content, what kind of data could be stored in the database, the structure of the database, that is schema, and the relationship between one or more tables, one or more files. We know that primary key is linked to the foreign key and so on. So what would be the relationship between the parent-child table? That we need to understand between the source table and the target table using the concept of profiling. So profiling is going to help us to understand the detailed information, the detailed quality of the data using some parameters, and those parameters are called as its dimensions: the inconsistency, the timeliness, the, you know, we call it as your missing values removal, and so on. Okay, so all these things has to be put up in the focus, and then we work on the creating the profile. And profile is always created on the raw data, the data which we get from the user, the client, that has to be profiled to understand the number of anomalies into it, right? So this is why we are going to create the profile. Also, the profiling helps us to understand the areas or the purpose for which the data is built up. Or for example, if I say my data contains the information about the educational institutes, right? But my end product should be somewhat related to IT industry, then educational industries play no, the data of educational industries play no role into the building up of projects related to IT industry. So the area, the concern of your data needs to be focused on. Similarly, you need to access and validate the metadata. Metadata is all about data about data. So you need to understand that what your data is, when it was created, who is the owner of the data, when it was last updated, and so on. So this is how we just look into the brief information, the brief conception about the source data by creating its profile. So this is the area of your profile and data quality, and today we are going to learn about how do we create the profiles. So let's begin with the practical. Now, coming back to my developer window, I'm having one data with me. So I open this data. This is data related to COVID-19. As we know that in today's period, there's a virus called as coronavirus, which has been spread all over the world. And this data, COVID-19, is basically the data about multiple regions, provinces, where this virus has spread out. This is the latitude and longitude of that regions, of that countries and regions, right? And these were the dates when the data was collected. And this column represents the confirmed cases in that particular country or region. This column represents the number of deaths which occurred. And this column represents the number of people who have recovered from this disease, right? So I'm going to create a profile of this data set. This is a data set which is in the CSV format, comma separated file format. I'm going to import this data. Already I've done this. I've imported this data into my developer, and I'm going to create a profile for this. So let me open my data in the developer. So this is my data set, COVID-19, right? Now I'm going to run this data set just to see it's working fine. So I'll just open the data viewer and run it. This data is all about the people who are surviving from the COVID-19 disease currently and who have recovered from that. And yes, the data is loaded into the data quality software. This is the data. It contains 1,000 rows and it contains your 8 columns. So the columns are province, state, country, latitude, longitude, date, confirmed cases, deaths, and recovered. Right? So this is your data all about. Okay. So what we're going to do is now is we're not going to create a profile for this data set. So to create a profile for this data set, I will just right click on my folder and I'll go to new and I'll click on the option called as profile. Now here I'm having three options: enterprise discovery profile, multiple profiles, and a simple profile. Now here we are going to choose the third option, that is called your profile. Profile, simple profile is also called as column profiling, a column level profile. So we just choose this option, third option. Click on next. Here I'm going to give a name to my profile. So I write COVID_profile. And this is the location where your profile will be saved. Let me change this location. So inside my folder, I have a folder, subfolder, profiles. I want to save my profile over there. Okay, now it asks you to add the data objects. Data object means the data, the file, whose profile you want to create. So I'll click on the add, and from my folder, I'm going to choose my data set. So COVID-19 is the data set. Click on OK and then click on next. Now these are basically the feature selections area of your profile. It's basically the area where you need to choose multiple operations, multiple features to build up the profile. Okay. So let's start with the very first one. The very first one is the column profiling. Under column profiling, I need to select those columns whose profile I want to create. Please note that it is not necessary to create the profile of all the columns. Since it is a column profiling is going to give you the detailed, minute information about each column individually, right? So it is not at all necessary to select all the columns, but it is necessary to select at least one column. So if I want to uncheck all the columns, it is going to give me an error. At least one column must be selected. So it by default, it will select the first column. I can select one or two more columns, right? So only the selected columns profile will be created. If I want to select all, I can just click on all. For now, I'm going to select all the columns. Then comes the second option called as data domain discovery. Now in data domain discovery, we go to the option called as data domain selection. Now here by data domain, I mean that what is the range of my data? For example, if I have a column, gender. In the gender column, there are basically three possible values: male, female, and transgender. So the domain of your gender column will be 3, right? Similarly, if I say states of India, now what is the range of states? What is the number of states in India? That is 29. So the domain of states of India is 29. No, the 30th value will not be a part of your states column in the country India. So domain is basically the range in which your data lies. Here, since we are performing only column level profiling, domain has no role into play. So we just don't select any of the domain here. Next is the column selection. The domain which we selected on the above option, that is data domain selection, that domain has to be applied on which column of the data set. That we will select here in the column selection. By default, since I have not selected any of the domain, so column selection will play no role into it. If I uncheck it, if I keep it checked, it will play no role into it. Then the next option is sampling options. Sampling means you need to run the profile on how many rows into the data set. So by default, it is all rows. So all the rows of your data set will be the part of the data profiling. The profile will be created on the values which are available in all the rows. If I want that only first n rows should be selected, profiling should run only first n rows, I can change the number of rows here. First, let's say 10. Okay. But if I want that the data should be applied on random rows, random number of rows, and the number of rows I can mention here is 20. So random 10 rows, right? Profiling will be created out of random 10 rows. The last option says random sample, and it says auto. In this case, the software automatically will pick out the random number of rows in the ratio of either 30-70 or 40-60. So either 40 rows will be taken as a random sample, or 60 will be taken as a random sample, or 30 will be taken as a random sample, or 70 will be taken as a random sample. So depending upon the wish of the software, whatever the logic is applied at the back end, it is going to pick up the automatically n number of rows, random rows from the data set, and run the profiling on that. But now I'm going to choose the option called as all rows, right? Then is filter. If you want to apply any kind of filter, because for example, I want that the rows should, which contain null values, should not be the part of my profiling. In that case, I can create a filter to filter out all the rows which contains the null values. And if I apply any kind of filter, those rows will not be a part of your profiling. Next is primary key profiling. If you want to choose any of your column as a primary key, you can select that, right? And then your functional dependency profiling. Again, if you're choosing a primary key at the top, you need to choose the foreign key at the bottom. So there is no need to make any changes into it. The last option is drill down options. Now, in case of drill down option, basically there are two options available to us, that is live data and staged data, right? Now, live data is basically the data which is coming from the real-time background, or which is coming from the real-time scenario, like your Twitter, or you can say ATM card transactions, etc. Now, when I do the drill down as live data, it is going to assume that my data is coming from the real-time background. Live streaming of data is there. Secondly, it will consume your maximum RAM. So to decrease the pressure on the RAM consumption, let me choose the second option, that is staged. Now, in case of staged data, we assume that data is already preloaded into the memory, right? And it is in the form of batched data. Batched means collected before execution. All the data is collected before execution. So it's a batch processing data is working here. The last option is run settings. Now, in this case, which environment we are using? Either we are using data integration service, that is native. Are we using Hive or we are using Hadoop? Now, Hive and Hadoop are the parts of your big data. We're not using the concept of big data here, so we'll just leave this option on to the native environment. So native is as it is, and click on finish. So when we click on finish, your profile will be created, right? We can go to the progress bar to check the status of the profile. So profile is being created right now. It will run a deep scanning operation on all the columns and all the rows of each column. So it is gonna take time, some time. Okay, so profile creation has been finished. Let's just open up the go to the results tab. My profile is currently open. Go to the results tab to see the results of the profile. So here you can see, I'll just drop down it to see my output. So I can see these are the outputs of my profile. This was created just now, right? And these are the outputs of my profile, results of my profile. Now here, it contains 19,500 rows. So 19,500 rows are there in my profile, right? And there are eight columns. And for each column, we are going to see some statistics, some output. So let's understand each column one by one. So if I click on this province state, which is my first column, you can see these are the details on the right. We can see the detail information about these column. The current detail information is showing you the values, right? Now, in this column province state, there are basically 13,500 rows, which is having null values, okay? And there are 75 rows, which contain Zhejiang values. There are 75 rows which contain Victoria value, and there are 75 rows which contain Tibet value. So this is the detailed information about the values available in the state column. this is the number of time of occurrence. Frequency means the number of time this value is occurring in that particular column. Right? So 13,500 stands for null value. It is empty. Right? Now next is percent. What is percent? So if I just add all the number of rows, what is the number of rows? 19,500. Right? So if I do the percentage of this value, it is 13,500 divided by 19,500 into 100. The percentage which I get is 69.23. So here percent represents the percentage of the frequency of a particular given value, right? So similarly, we have a chart. A chart represents the bar representation of this value, percent and the frequency, okay? Now, similarly, we have country. If I go to country, you can see China. China is having frequency of 2475. China is coming 2475 in my rows. Similarly, Zambia. Zambia is coming 75 times in my column. And this is the percentage representation of these frequency values. And there is a chart. So on with the other columns. We have date, right? 4520. That is 260 times this value 4520. 5th April 2020 is coming, and so on. And then you have recovered. So recovered means 10, there are 10, the value 10 is coming for how many times? 129 times in the given column. Okay. Now, if I come back to this basic statistics, this is your column name. This is the distinct value. In the column province, how many distinct values are there? Distinct means different values. So there are 80 distinct values in the province state column. And this is the percentage of the distinct value. Out of 100, let's suppose 100 values, if there are 40 distinct values, then the percentage would be 40%. Okay. So this is how we are getting the distinct percentage. In the province state column, how many null values are there? So the null values are 13,500, and this is the null percentage which you are getting out of it. Okay. Then is the data type. Okay. So this province state column is having which data type? It is having the string data type, and the maximum length of the value is 33. So if I say there is a value called as Western Australia, the length of this value will be the total value of my this column, province column or state column. Okay. So this is dynamic. The length of a particular column will be dynamic depending upon the value which is having the maximum length in that particular column. Okay. So this is all about your profile in the developer. Now next, if I go to the details, I have an option called as patterns. Okay, so let's understand what is patterns. Okay, for this, I'll go to province state. Now, pattern means the data type. I repeat, it means data type. Now to make it understand, let's have a example of it. Okay, so if I say, the value is ABC, right? ABC. Now, each character in pattern is represented via X. Each character in pattern, in string, given string is represented via X, right? Now, here, the pattern for this would be X, X, X. For the value ABC, the pattern will be XXX. If I say Aman, okay. Now for this, what will the pattern? The pattern is, character is represented by X, and the length will be represented by 4. Okay. So the pattern for this value will be 4. Similarly, if I have a number, let's take it as 2. Now for this, the pattern will be 9. Because number are represented by 9. Okay. Then if I say I have a number 33, this will be represented by 99. Here, single 9 represents single length, double 9 represents two digits. Okay. If I have a number 3, 4, 5, 6. Now in this case, the pattern will be, the length will be represented by 9 bracket 4. Okay. Now this is your pattern. Now in some cases, what happens? We leave a particular string as empty. Like we use inverted quotes to represent the string, but we don't put any data into this inverted quotes. Now this is represented by a pattern called as others. See, if I'm keeping it as empty, in that case it will be null. But if I'm not keeping it as empty, I am using the string to represent the character, but the value is not given. In that case, it is others. Okay. If I'm not entering the value, it is null. If I'm using the quotes to represent a particular character, but I forgot to mention that character, in that case, it will be under the category of others. So this is all about your patterns. Okay. Now, coming back to your developer, you can see in this prevent state, there are 2, 3, 2, 5 values which are coming under the category of others. They are kept empty, intentionally. Okay. Then is null. There are 13,500 values which are under the category of null. Okay. And there are 1200 values which are having the length of 7 characters. Right. And there are 300 values which are having the length of the given word as 9 characters. Okay. So pattern represents the length of your value. So this is basically all about your patterns. Let's go to statistics. Now statistics are very good to look into it. Now if I take a column provinch, okay, what is the maximum length of your character? Let me just go back to patterns once. What is the maximum length of your character? What is the maximum length of your character? So coming back to statistics, it says maximum length is 33. Maximum length is 33. That means if I go back to my patterns, can I see any of the value with x33? No. X33? No. But in case it may be possible that I have kept on this space bar or space in 33 characters. So it is coming under the category of others. So assume that there are 33 spaces in a given field which is coming under the category of others, and it is giving you the character maximum length as 33. Okay. Then comes minimum length is 5. Let me just go back. Minimum length is 5. So as I can see, x7, x5, x8, 6, 10, 9. So minimum among them is 5. So I have a character which is having the smallest length, that is 5. Null is not counted as any of the length, right? So go back to your statistics. Then is bottom. Bottom means when I sort the province state column in the descending order. I repeat, I sort the column in the descending order value. Now, what are the values which are appearing at the bottom of the column values? So, at the bottom, there are basically these values which are coming. So, Alberta at the bottom, last bottom, right? And Julia at the second last bottom, and Hui at the third last bottom, Aruba at the fourth last bottom, and Australian Capital Territory at the fifth last bottom. Now what is happening? I am sorting the province state column in the descending order of alphabetically wise. Then when I sort it, I get some bottom values, and that bottom values are represented in my statistics. Similarly, I have top 5. Again, sorting your province column in the descending order, I get some values and those sorted values are the from the top are the Xinjiang, Yunnan, Yukon, Xinjiang and Western Australia. So they are sorted in alphabetically order from descending. Okay, so this is your statistics. Let's go to some value which is death, a number value. Okay, now you must have seen here in the province state column, we don't have any statistics about minimum, maximum, average, etc. But if my column is a numerical column, in that case I will get some more statistics like average value, standard deviation, maximum length, minimum length, sum, right? And then we have bottom, from the bottom which are the five values, and from the top which are the five values, right? So this is all about your statistics in the profile. And then I go to my last point, which is called the data types. Now data types is basically the representation of the data type which could be followed in the particular column. So if I go to the province state column, I can see the data type used was string. Okay, the data type used was string. If I go to country region, I see the data type used is string. If I go to latitude, I see that data type used is string, but it could be possible that we can use date time, we can use date time mm year, we can use date time hh 24 minute. But if I look into the logic of my column, latitude has no role to play with the date time format. Latitude gives you the value in terms of degrees, so it is not going to have any relation with the date time. So date time should not have been used here. That is why we have used here decimal or string. Okay, probably is to use the decimal, because when you want to do any arithmetic operations on the latitude and longitude columns, you cannot do on string values. Okay, so try to use decimal here. So this is all about your profile. Now this is a profiling which we have analyzed in the developer. If I want to analyze the profiling in the analyst software, for that I can just open my analyst software, right? Here I'll just write my IP, so it's 192.16. This is my analyst. This is my analyst browser window. I'll just type in my password. Username, login. When you log in, you need to go to your services and notes. On the services and notes, you have a service called as analyst. Open this. There's a link which you can open it up to open your analyst tool. So this is your analyst tool here, right? Now here I'm going to go to my manage and open the projects. Okay, now here I'm going to go to the open folder. Click on the open icon to get the library. Go to the projects, open your project from here, right? And open your profile. So click on profiles, click on profile, we'll get all the profiles which are there in your folder. So COVID profile is the profile which we just created. Click on this profile, your profile will get open the analyst tool. Okay, so this is your analyst tool. Now you can see that here there are 8 columns, right? Now this is giving you basically brief information about your profile. Why we are using analyst tool? Analyst tool is a tool which is basically used by the business people, clients, to just verify whether the data given by them is good in a quality matter or not. So they just want to see that whatever the developer has done, is it correct or not? And when we say that business people are looking into this analyst tool, we assume that they have a knowledge about how to use this analyst tool. Okay, so they are going to look into the data which they gave to the developer to just make it good quality wise. And they're going to look at that provenance state is having how many null values. That is your 69.23%. It is having 0.41% of distinct values and 30.35% of non-distinct values. Okay, and the value range from Alberta to last Xinjiang. Okay, so this is your pattern. This is your maximum length. 5 is your minimum length and 33 is the maximum length. This is the data type which has been used in this province column. We have done this. I believe we have done all this, understood all this in the developer tool itself. Similar is for your country, latitude, and then you have longitude and so on. Right? Now, if I want to see the detailed information about a particular column, so for that I can just click on a particular column and I can see that this is your information about a profile. We have in the column, that is your province state, there are 80 distinct values. 80, that means distinct means 80 non-unique values and 0 unique values. And there are 1350 null values, 80 distinct values, and then you can see 5920 non-distinct values. Okay, then you can see on the bottom, you can see these are the null values. It is going to give you the information which are null and which are not null. These are the string data types it is following you. It is giving you the pattern, right? It is giving you the pattern. It is giving you the values, length, minimum, max, data preview. You can preview your data also. Okay. And then if you have applied any kind of data domain, you can see here. So this is like detailed information about your profile, the detailed which the client wants to see. Okay, so this is all about your profile. One thing I would like to tell you is, like, we create a profile in the developer, but it is being analyzed in the analyst tool. Okay, so whatever I see in developer tool, they are being understood briefly in the analyst tool, but the modifications could not be made on the analyst tool. Okay, so this is all about your profiling. If you have any kind of doubt, do let me know. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.